गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट केमिकल फॉर्मूले विच इज़ द सिम्बॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन और शॉर्ट हैंड रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ इट्स कॉम्पोजिशन. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस लर्न हाउ टू राइट केमिकल फॉर्मूले. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द रूल्स फॉर राइटिंग द केमिकल फॉर्मूले विच इज़ Write the symbols formula of the elements or ions so that the symbol of the metal or positive ion is on the left and the symbol formula of the non-metal or the negative ion is on the right. So the first rule about writing a chemical formula is that the positive ions should be written on the left and the negative ions or non-metal should be written on the right hand side. The second is write the valences of the elements or ions below the elements or ions. So the valences should be written below the elements. Third is cross over the valences of the combining ions. So after writing the valences, we have to cross over the valences of the ions. The fourth one is the polyatomic ions should be enclosed in bracket before writing the formula. So if there is any polyatomic ions in making the formula, then it should be enclosed within a bracket. Now let us see some examples and follow these rules to write the chemical formula. So let us first talk about HCl, hydrochloride, how this hydrochloride HCl formula is written. So first of all, you have to write the symbol of the compound. So we are talking about hydrogen chloride. So firstly, we have to write the symbols of these atoms. Now after writing the symbols of this atom, their valences are placed just below them, like here it is done. So firstly, we have written the symbol and then below them we have written the valences. Now these valences are shifted crosswise, as you can see with the help of arrows, to the lower right of these atoms as shown in the figure, as shown over here. So this is known as crossover or crisscross of the valencies. So firstly you have to write the symbol, then you have to write the valencies below them, and after that you have to crisscross the valencies, and then you will get the formula as HCl. One thing more over here, in the formula of the compound, the valency 1 is normally omitted. So we never write H1 or Cl1. So 1 is basically omitted. So simply we write HCl. Now let us see one more example of hydrogen sulfide. Same thing, firstly you have to write the symbol. For hydrogen it is H, and for sulfide, the symbol for sulfide is S2 negative. So this is the symbol for sulfide. So firstly we have written the symbols. The next step is to write the valencies below them. The valency for hydrogen is 1 and for sulfide is 2. So in the 2 negative, and in the formula basically the positive and the negative signs are generally omitted. So simply we write 2, not 2 negative. Now we crisscross the valencies, we cross over the valencies to the lower right of these atoms, and we come with the formula as H2S. Now let us see one more example, that is of magnesium chloride. Symbol for magnesium is Mg and for chloride is Cl. Basically the symbol is Cl negative 1. So here negative 1 is the valency for chloride. The next step is to write the valency. The valency for magnesium is 2 and for chloride is 1. Now we cross over these valencies and we get the formula as MgCl2. Now let us see more examples. Let us see the example for calcium oxide. Now how to write the formula for calcium oxide? Write the symbol for calcium, which is Ca. The symbol for oxide is O. Now the valency for calcium is 2 and for oxide is 2. Now you can see 2 here, and 2 here is the common factor. So in the case when there is common factor, it has to be taken out. So it can be simplified as 1. 2 will be cancelled out with the 2 and we get 1. So the formula for calcium oxide comes out to be CaO. We never write this. Whenever there is common factor, we have to omit that out. We have to cancel that out. And this ratio should be in the this valences should be in the simplest ratio, and we get the formula as CaO. I hope this point is clear to you all. Now let us see one more example. Let us say of calcium hydroxide. The formula for calcium is Ca, and the symbol or formula for hydroxide is OH. Now the valency for calcium is 2 and for hydroxide it is 1, and when we cross over these valencies we get CaOH2. Why we have put bracket over here? Because hydroxide is a polyatomic ion and it should be always enclosed in a bracket. So I hope now it is clear how to write chemical formulae. For writing chemical formulae, you have to follow the certain rules which we have just discussed in the beginning, and most important, as I have told you in the previous video, you have to learn the valencies of the first 18 elements and of the polyatomic ions. If you don't know the valencies as well as the symbols of the elements, you will not be able to write chemical formulae. So it is very important to learn to memorize that table. So I am repeating here.